हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर अमित गुप्ता। वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल हेल्थ इज मस्ट। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ सीरीज इन विच वी विल टॉक अबाउट एवरी टाइप ऑफ कैंसर। सो इन दिस सीरीज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एंडोमेट्रियल कैंसर मीन्स यूट्राइन कैंसर। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू नो वट इज एंडोमेट्रियल कैंसर, वट आर द सिम्टम्स, रिस्क फैक्टर्स and how can we diagnose uterine cancer. In last, what is the treatment of uterine cancer. So first of all, what is endometrial cancer? It is a type of cancer that begins in the uterus. Endometrial cancer is also called uterine cancer. What are the other types of cancer that can be formed in uterus? These are uterine sarcoma, but they are very less common than endometrial cancer. Now, what are the symptoms of uterine cancer? First of all and most common is vaginal bleeding, mainly after menopause, and bleeding between periods. Abnormal blood is discharged from your vagina. Now, what are the symptoms of uterine cancer? First of all and most common is vaginal bleeding, mainly after menopause, and bleeding between periods. Abnormal blood is discharged from your vagina. Pelvic pain may be there. Now, what are the risk factors for uterine cancer? First of all, PCOS or PCOD means polycystic ovarian syndrome or polycystic ovarian disease. Second one is obesity. Yes, obesity is also a risk factor for uterine cancer. As we know in my early video, obesity is a risk factor for most of the disease. So please control obesity with very good diet control and doing regular exercise. The women who are obese, they are more prone for uterine cancer approximately 3 times than non-obese ladies. Other risk factors are old age, endometrial hyperplasia, no pregnancy, and family history of uterine cancer, previous radiation therapy to the pelvis, and tamoxifen drug, which is used to treat women who have breast cancer, and it is also used to help prevent breast cancer in women. Those are at high risk. Now we will know how can we diagnose uterine cancer. In this, endometrial biopsy is needed to confirm a diagnosis of endometrial cancer. And what are the other tests that can be done? Transvaginal pelvic ultrasound, hysteroscopy, DNC, dilatation and curettage. Now, we will know the main part of this video, that is treatment of uterine cancer. Surgery is the most common treatment for uterine cancer. It can be either laparoscopic or open. Standard surgery for endometrial cancer is the removal of uterus with the removal of attached ovary and fallopian tubes. In many cases, your doctor will also recommend removal of lymph nodes from the abdomen and pelvis depending upon the stage of uterine cancer. Next one is radiation. It is most frequently used after surgery, but in some cases it may be used before surgery to reduce the mass of cancer or for some other indications. Next one is chemotherapy, that will kill cancer cells, and chemotherapy given to the patient whose cancer has spread at the time of diagnosis. Now, hormone therapy, this drug given by mouth or by injection. Hormone therapy is used to treat widespread disease or cancer that return. Now, what are the key points of this topic? First, uterine cancer is the growth of abnormal cells in the lining of uterus. Second, surgery is the main way to treat most types of cancer, mainly uterine cancer. You can reduce your risk for uterine cancer by avoiding risk factor and early reporting of symptoms to your doctor. Fourth, post radiotherapy and chemotherapy may be required depending upon the stage and other factors. I hope this video will be helpful for you to know about uterine cancer. If you like this video, give me one thumbs up for this video and do not forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and please press bell icon button to get notified. So thank you very much.